First, I want to bring up the item that I pulled from the agenda. This is not a slight against the person who applied. It's about the process that led to this decision. There were two people who applied for the Zoning Board of Appeals. Person who was selected said that they lived within the corporate city limits. They live out in Portsmouth Township, so that should have been a flag to possibly have that reviewed. And with no information in the packet, I don't know if it is or not, because they live on Knight Road. Person who was not selected lives on North Van Buren, which is obviously in the city, and they also have a building trades background, according to their application. Again, I did not go to an interview, so I don't know if there is some information I'm missing, but based off of the two pieces of paper in the packet, the person who should have been selected should have been the person who lives in the city first, if they have applicable experience in the field, and they appeared to. Other thing I wanted to note tonight was I found a piece of paper that had, it was actually from Bridge Partners, about the tolling restrictions, and it had a chart on the bottom that I had not seen in this chamber yet about the restrictions by class. We also went with the vehicle pictures showing, you know, two-axle vehicles, trucks, cars, minivans are part of the free with your transponder for city residents. But underneath that, there is a vehicle class information for restrictions to dimensions. A vehicle greater than 7 feet is no longer free. A vehicle with a length of over 21 feet is no longer free. And they measure that by the cameras, apparently. And that's the nose to tail of the moving object through the sensor. Which means if you drive a Chrysler Pacifica or Chevrolet Suburban and you have a mobility scooter attached to your trailer, bang, you're over 21 feet. If you are someone who likes to lift to trucks, which is not my thing, but I know a lot of people do, you're likely cracking that 7 foot tower. There, that chart with the height restrictions and width restrictions, I don't remember seeing in here in the presentations we got from Bay City Bridge Partners. Along with that, to my knowledge, they have not sent out actual invoices to people who need to physically pay per charge. And we're coming on 7 months. These people are going to have to renew tabs soon. If those are pending in the background, are they going to be told when they go to renew it at Secretary of State, sorry, you have to go pay this bill that they may not have seen yet? That process was supposed to be ironed out beforehand. I know that was brought up here a couple times by a couple commissioners that was supposed to be ironed out, and it appears it has not been. So that's something to look into, because that's going to get it's disturbing. It's been over 6 months. And then finally, when I saw the presentation for Hay Bay City, I did some snooping of my own using publicly available information just to kind of compare and contrast. And it was noted that the social media numbers fell, and I found the same thing on mine. But I saw a click-through rate on the Facebook of about 1.1% and on Instagram of about 1.5%, with a serious outlier of one item posting their 30-day click-through to 2.2. One item upped at almost a whole percentage of engagement. But the one that was a huge discrepancy between what I was able to find and what was on the sheet here was total views. Because he put total views and it was like thousands and tens of thousands of views and clicks. I have I found a service that does organic traffic, which is based off of individualized devices. So each individual device that went to this website in the past 6 months showed a total of 437 different devices access Hay Bay City. That's it, 437. I mean, I can only trust this as far as I can look into it, but that is a massive discrepancy between the amount that was put on this screen earlier this evening. On top of that, the job board, it was noted there was 111 jobs. When I looked on last Thursday, there were 110. Of those, over half of them are considered dormant by most other job boards, meaning they've been there for over a month. 27, all belonging to Garber Linwood, have been up there for over a year. I doubt they are trying to flip their entire staff at a car dealership all at once for a year straight. That's a problem. I don't feel like there's enough complete information there. When it was noted about the total podcast plays, most services count 10 seconds as a podcast play. Do we have an average length to see how much traction these are getting outside of that, just to see how much is reaching here? Just information I'd want to know, because it seems like we have things that are missing. Some of the larger employees that were on that job board, was the largest one was Garber Linwood, again, 27 jobs. SBSC with 24, 14 of which were over a month old. Seven of Michigan Sugars were over a month old. Six from SK Siltron, four from Fabiano, and three from the other companies were over that. So we're looking at about 50 jobs that were considered current. And a lot of those are jobs that people who are around here probably didn't qualify for, where they found them on a different job site, which they're just using a job board called TrueJob, which is just a plugin, which is why I don't know if the numbers for that are correct too, because that plugin would also show on TrueJob itself, which clicks on TrueJob as well as wherever that is linked in on the website. So that 1,000 clicks for applications may have been from Hey Bay City, but may have been from TrueJob or from a different service that uses TrueJob that is not supported by the city. They just post whatever they want on their website. There's no way for me to tell that without having a TrueJob account, and I'm not paying for that. But there's some questions with the service that I know we're paying a decent amount for, and I know that he's posted that they're going to be creating one in Saginaw.
Mr. DeWitt, I'm sorry, your time's up. I actually gave you 30 extra seconds. If somebody wants to give you some more time, they can make a motion.
Mr. Daca.
Thank you. Motion for 2 additional minutes.
I won't need that. They are also be creating a Saginaw version of...
Wait a second.
I thought I had a second.
Commissioner Nijinsky.
Nijvetsky. Second.
Okay.
All right, you'll have...
I thought I had a second. Creating a second service very similar in Saginaw, whereas it looks like it could be a competing service, where we should be working together with the city of Saginaw and the county of Saginaw, as well as this project is also working with county or with Bay County to possibly do more regional integration. And having two split services that may be fighting each other for the same eyeballs. Thank you.